getting away from it all, leaving the big smoke and going bush. Most of us dream of doing it, but few do, and fewer still do it as successfully as Stanley Breeden and Bill Cooper. Stan and Bill built houses near each other in wilderness country behind Cairns, and now each day spend hours in the rainforest, just looking at life. And since Stan is a writer and Bill an artist, they've been able to share it with all of us. The two friends chose one of the wettest places in Australia to get away from it all. But that's what makes it special. The rainforest is teeming with life. Even shy creatures, like the rifle bird, are now old friends. Bill, how did you ever get him to do that?
Well, with a lot of patience. Yeah, I started him feeding on just a piece of fruit on the bird table, and then he, each time I'd put fruit out, I'd just stay a bit longer and let him, and he gradually let me get a bit closer over and took about a couple of years. There he is, the rifle.
That's beautiful.
It's Bill Cooper's patience and his eye for this kind of beauty that's made him one of the world's greatest bird artists.
It's the male, the female. This is not quite finished yet. I'm still, as you can see, the foot's missing, and I'm working on some moss and branches and stuff to come up here yet.
There's a few from the forest today.
Oh, God, that's the one I'll paint, I think.
Yeah.
Bill's neighbour, Stanley Breeden, is a naturalist and writer. Their unique collaboration might never have happened had they both not fallen in love with the same corner of Australia.
Bill Cooper, he was up here first. I've been coming here for many years, of course, and he found this amazing piece of rainforest not far from here. And about that time when I was visiting him, I was about ready to find a place of my own as well.
After wandering the world, writing, filming and photographing the beauties of nature, this is the place Stan settled on, a tropical rainforest where he could study the plants and the animals right outside his front door. With one of the richest collections of life on Earth unfolding before his eyes, Stan kept a detailed diary of his first year living here. It's a very personal vision of a rainforest.
Should we enter the forest in a hushed reverence, as we might a cathedral? Certainly not. Enter it as a living, vibrant place, full of life, colour, drama and excitement. Rainforest is not built, it grows. It is not on a human scale. It's way beyond that.
How much of this wildlife just comes walking right by your front window here?
Well, just about all of it. I worked out just recently that within the, just by the house here, I have seen every species of bird that lives in this forest has come past at some time or another. And just about all the mammals too.
The pen and the brush together have given us a portrait of life in the rainforest.
They are no longer specimens to be dispassionately observed. They have become individuals, neighbours, and part of my everyday life. The place does make some kind of sense.
One of Stan's favourite places is his platypus pool.
every now and again you come down here, there's one sort of swimming, and you see them rise to the top, and they float for a while and chew all the animals they've caught in the mud below, and they go down again. And yeah, quite often in different pools. I don't know just how many there are on the place, but I'd say about four or five.
The platypus pool is a feature of the book. The bush magic is captured through Bill's painting and Stan's words.
Suddenly I notice something dark and brown, speeding up from the dark depths of the pool. A platypus surfaces almost at my feet.
Here's another nice buttress. Watch your head here.
Take a walk with Stan through his rainforest and you begin to see how all life here is interconnected.
What's this?
These are the fruit of one of the hazelwood trees. And the pigeons just love them, you know, and actually the painting that's built, that's done for the book, is of a purple-crowned pigeon feeding on these fruit on the racine. The colour is quite amazing, some of these fruits.
The pigeon can eat it, can we?
I don't know. You'd like to try that one.
If I fall over?
Yeah. Interesting. Pretty bitter, isn't it?
No.
And try this bush, you know, try... Pick a leaf and crush it and smell it. Not too... Don't deep breathe.
Oh, God! It's putrid.
Yeah.
What is that?
Well, that's why it's called a fart bush.
You're kidding.
The book gives me the feeling that there's still so many mysteries about the rainforest, that it's a very mysterious place.
To us, it's very friendly. I feel very friendly and very at home in the rainforest now, but... It still holds lots of mysteries, and just about every time we walk in the forest, we'll find something that's different or new we haven't seen. And, so you could say it's mysterious.
You say in your book that some of the most wonderful things in the rainforest are in the leaf cover.
Yeah, well, you see after all this rain we've had, you see all these fungi that have come up. Well, these are actually the fruiting bodies of the fungi. You see, and there's all kinds of them, beautiful colours and shapes. Lots and lots of little tiny animals at work here, down to microscopic size. And it's just a seething world, very, very active all the time, even more active than what we see, but at such a small scale that most of us are not aware of it.
And you find new things all the time, or new for me, not new to science or anything like that. And I can remember the day when I first found the bower of the golden bowerbird, which I'd been looking for years. A thrill that's hard to describe, but it's sort of a feeling of great privilege in a way that you share your place with these amazing birds.
Bill made some sketches of the bower's decorations. The bowerbird collects yellow lichen, seeds, and white orchid flowers and displays them to attract the female.
By just going out and standing quietly around, he comes around while I'm there. And I was able to sketch his bower and get sketches of him hopping around.
This is another kind of bowerbird?
This is the tooth-billed bowerbird. And as you can see, clears a patch on the forest floor and then selects special species of leaves which he lays around on the clearing, the underside up. And if you were to turn one over, he would come back later and turn it back again. He sits on a perch and sings away to the female, to attract the female down, and if she comes down, he then darts down and gets behind the bottom of this tree, for instance, and chirs away to get her down. As she comes down, then he charges out and does his display to her.
Bill and Stan have front row seats at a wildlife spectacular. And the star of the show is undoubtedly the giant cassowary.
I love cassowaries in the forest. They're just amazing birds. They're just so big and so quiet.
While Bill is famous around the world for his bird paintings, His next project is still life. He's trying to paint every fruit in the rainforest.
How many are you finding?
Well, we're averaging about 100 a year. I've been working on it now for 5 years, and every year it seems that we manage to find 100 new species. There are over 2,000 species out there that, and we'll keep on finding fruit, so I'll keep on painting them.
In the rainforest, you've never seen it all. At night, Bill and Stan explore a whole new world.
There's something there, see? Oh, yeah.
There are the possums, which are just magnificent here, and we have a greater variety here than most places. And in the fig trees, you often see the green possum, which is probably my favourite of the possums up here.
After a year in the rainforest, through all of its seasons, Stan was even more in love with the place. He'd walked into this mysterious world, fascinated by its secrets and its complexity. But just by living with it and keeping his eyes open, slowly he was coming to terms with the rainforest towards the end of the diary.
This ancientness and the Australianness concentrated in this tiny wet corner of the huge continent have for me been the great discoveries of the last year. It has been a journey into Gondwana.
It's a beautiful partnership you and Bill have, the pen and the brush. Do you think you've done justice to the rainforest?
Oh, I don't think so, really. It's such a magnificent place that you need a lifetime to, and probably 10 volumes to really do it all.
No, I couldn't do justice to all that beauty. I just tried, but what I produce always falls short of what I would like to be able to produce.
Nature is the masterpiece.
Oh, for sure.